Hi everybody, my name is Max. Welcome to the Synthesis Labs here in the Rosenthal Group. Here in the Rosenthal Group, we have 8 total hoods, 4 rotovaps, 2 ovens for drying off our glassware. In each hood, we have 2 to 3 stir plates, as well as a shank line for our occasional air-free techniques that we need to utilize. Hey, Jan, what you doing over there?
Hey Max, I'm purifying one of my buffering noise using the column, and then I will collect the fractions using the rotovap.
Sounds good, Jan. Now, if you look into this lab here, you can see one of our actual battery tests by my coworker Lynn on one of our 5 potentio sets on mobile parts, so we can do our analysis wherever we need to. Hey, Anthony, what you doing down there?
Hello, I'm using our Biotage automated chromatography unit in order to purify one of our bilodine samples.
Last thing I want to show you guys here in the Synthesis Lab is our still system for our solvents. Here we have 8 different solvents that we keep air-free and dry as we go through a nice purification process, particularly some difficult ones, such as THF, aceto, and DMF. I'm actually about to dispense some benzene for our dry box now.
I'm Winkle, and this is Hannah. We are both country graduate students in Geographic School, and I'm very glad to show you our drop boxes. As you can see, here are 3 drop boxes in this room, which helps us a lot to deal with the air sensitive materials and reactions. Here is a single drop box, mainly used for the electrochemistry of the nitrogen atmosphere. And this is a double drop box, mainly for the organic synthesis. And standing behind is another double drop box for the reactions containing water but air sensitive. And now, Tiana will show you some examples about the life in the drop box.
Okay, so when doing electrochemical experiments in the glove box, obviously we can't bring our potentiostat into the glove box, so we have external connections. So we have our cores of potentiostat connected to external cores, which then lets us do electrochemical experiments in the glove box. We also have a port for UV-Vis in case we need to do UV-Vis spectroscopy in the glove box as well. So some examples. So here we do have a setup of a single cell with our connections to the potentiostat. And some experiments that we could do are things such as a CV, DPV, and bulk electrolysis experiments for our materials.
Hello, welcome to the photochemistry lab. This is where we do all of our photochemistry for our tetrapyrrol projects. Here we have one of our fluorimeters that we use for our singlet oxygen studies. We also have a light source here with a variety of light filters in order to irradiate our samples at any particular wavelength. Over here we have a UV-Vis spectrophotometer in order to do our absorption and Beer's law studies. And then finally, we have our second fluorimeter that we use for our emission studies. It has a more sensitive detector in order for us to detect low levels of phosphorescence for our compounds.
Hello, my name is Lynn.
Hi, I'm Yusha, and I study small molecule activation using tetrapyrrol compounds.
We use the cryo UV-Vis to study low temperature. This low temperature will allow us to study the kinetics of small molecules activation. This device uses nitrogen to defrost the size of the beauty viz. And because I'm an independent woman who needs no man, I turn on the nitrogen myself. I'll let you try pour in the liquid nitrogen though. Alright, we set the temperature to negative 40 degrees Celsius, drop the UV vis cuvette inside, and here's the spectra.
Hello, I'm Lou. So here we have two potential sets that's coupled with SRI gas chromatography. So with this setup, we're able to run electrolysis on the various gas phase and detect the gas product quantitatively. So for example, we can electro deposit some inexpensive catalysts such as bismuth, tin, on the glossy carbon electrode. So and then we can perform electrolysis and then detect the gas product. So it depends in the presence of alkali liquid. So depends on the nature of the catalyst for the composition of the electrolyte, the CO2 reduction gas product that can be detected on the SRI chromatography. And Tabiso also performed some experiments related to the electrochemical catalysis.
Hi, I'm Tabiso. So I work in the CO2 reduction product as well. And for my project, I do a lot of electroanalytical chemistry. And besides the regular potential start, I use also a bipotential start, which is a really nice instrument that allows us to control two working electrodes at the same time. For example, in this setup that I'm working on here, I'm using a rotating disk electrode to control the mass transport of our ionic liquid solutions when we're doing the electrochemistry. So besides the RDE electrodes, we also, in the bipotential start, we have access to several other really nice techniques, such as impedance and square wave voltammetries, which you can't really do with regular potential starts. And we also share these bipotential starts with the synthesis group, where they use it to study the oxygen reduction reaction as well.